Hey guys, how's it going? Younger Dirty 89 with you guys. First off, thanks for checking out the channel. As always, feel free to like, share, subscribe, get to take a look at some other videos. So I recently bought not only my first, but my second suppressor. What I wanted to do in this video is kind of explain to you guys how the process went. I explained to you guys why I decided to buy a suppressor now, why I think now is the time to buy a suppressor, and also let you know what suppressors I bought. So to understand about suppressors first, you have to understand why suppressors are an NFA item. An NFA item is an item that you have to go through a process to get. Similar NFA items would be short barrel rifles, short barrel shotguns, and suppressors. People will ask, are they suppressors or are they silencers? Well, technically by the government's definition, they are entitled silencers, but most people refer to them as suppressors, or CANs is the cool term, the tactical term, and everything like that. So suppressors fall under a category called the National Firearms Act of 1934. The National Firearms Act of 1934 was an act to basically make it hard to obtain silencers or suppressors, whatever you want to call them, short-barreled rifles, short-barreled shotguns, and destructive devices. So basically what they did back in 1934 was they made a process that was going to be pretty hard for the average person to go through. They also made a tax of $200, which is still the same today, and that tax was made to kind of discourage people from getting them. Back in 1934, just from some quick little stats here, back in 1934, $200 was equivalent to $3,653.52 in today's money. Also, back in 1934, a brand new house cost $5,970, and the average person made $1,600 a year. Nowadays, a good job, people are making $1,000 a week. So times have definitely changed. Gas was 10 cents a gallon. Right now, I think gas in my state is like 3-something a gallon. So there's definitely a big difference in times, but the tax stamp has always stayed the same at $200. Now, there are acts that are actually, you know, being held in front of Congress and stuff as we speak right now, such as the National Hearing Act or the HPA Hearing Protection Act and SHUSH, and there's some other different acts. Basically, what they're trying to do is they're trying to take suppressors off of the NFA list, which I definitely agree with. And a lot of people in the industry are interested in suppressors, but maybe don't own a suppressor. We each have our different reasons for why we don't own them, whether we don't want to deal with the weight, deal with the paperwork, or whether we just don't want to pay Uncle Sam $200 for something and then have to pay for it. So, you know, a lot of people are holding out for that HPA to go through. And the reason why I decided to buy a suppressor now, the reason why I think now is the time if you really want a suppressor, is because if that HPA or SHUSH Act or any of them ever do go through, you're going to see suppressors being sold out really quick. Even right now in the times we're in where you have to pay $200 for a tax stamp, there's still companies such as Silencer Shop, which we're going to refer to several times in this video, because they're kind of the big dealer of silencers. They're constantly sold out of this suppressor or that suppressor. Imagine whenever silencers get taken off of the HP or get taken off the NFA list, you're going to see silencers be sold out for at least a year. Also, the price is going to go up. Some people are saying, well, the price isn't going to go up. Yeah, it is. It's basic economics. It's supply and demand. You're going to see a lot of people wanting to buy suppressors, and companies are going to raise the price up a little bit. Also, right now, suppressors don't have an excise tax. What an excise tax is it's a tax that's built into the cost of an item. For example, in some states, if you're a smoker — I'm not a smoker, but this is just the simplest example — for example, in Pennsylvania, cigarettes are more expensive than in West Virginia or Ohio. A lot of people from Pennsylvania that live close to the border will go to West Virginia or Ohio to buy cigarettes simply because they're cheaper there because of the excise tax. Pennsylvania has a higher excise tax. It's going to work the same way with silencers or suppressors, whatever you want to call them. They don't have an excise tax on them right now. I guarantee you if they get taken off of the NFA list, there's going to be a tax. Now, is that tax going to be $200 like it is now? Probably not. I don't necessarily think that it will be, but it's something that's going to raise the price of it in conjunction with the supply and demand that's going to probably equal out to about what you're going to pay for a suppressor or silencer right now. Also, again, we said they're going to be sold out for a while. So I definitely think if you're interested in a suppressor, now is kind of the time to get one. So if I haven't already convinced you to buy a suppressor, well, I guess I'm not, you know, I don't deal with suppressors. I mean, I just bought my first two, but I just kind of wanted to let you guys know that, because a lot of my buddies, and I was in the same boat, I was saying, oh, I'm going to wait for the HPA to go through. I'm going to wait for that. And then after really doing some research and really thinking about it, I finally realized that this is how it's going to be. So anyways, guys, moving along with the video, let's get to what you're probably most interested in. how the process went. So again, this was my first time ever buying a suppressor, and I went about it a couple different ways. I tried to see what options there are to buy suppressors. Well, you can either go through your local gun dealer, who may or may not be associated with Silencer Shop, and you can go through them. Some of them are going to be a little different than others. For example, the two that I went to that weren't associated with Silencer Shop in my area basically told me you're going to have to get two passport photos, two sets of fingerprints, and you're going to have to do all kind of paperwork, and don't come back till you have that stuff. The other option is to go through Silencer Shop or one of their many affiliated dealers. Silencer Shop deals in silencers. Silencers are kind of a pain in the butt to buy because you have all the paperwork and got to deal with all the shit. So it's a smart business move for Silencer Shop to try to make the process as smooth and easy as possible. And that benefits us consumers because it makes it smooth and easier on us. So I definitely suggest ordering through Silencer Shop unless you have a really good dealer local to you. Silencer Shop, you know, they know what they're doing and they make the process easy for us. So if you're deciding to order a suppressor through Silencer Shop, essentially what you're going to want to do is, number one, figure out which suppressor you want. They make suppressors for 30 caliber guns, 5.56 guns, 45s, 9mm, 22s. I've even seen suppressors for like 338s, and I'm sure there's suppressors for really anything out there that you want to get. The most commonly bought suppressors, I would say, would probably be 22s, 9mm, 45s, and 30 cals. Now, the trend in the market is to buy a big can and use it for small stuff. For example, buy a 30 cal can, use it on 30 caliber guns, and also be able to use it on 5.56. Same thing with a pistol, buy a 45 can, that way you can use it on 45 and 9. Buy a 22 can that's rated for 22 Magnum, that way you can use it for 22 Magnum, 22 long rifle, and your 17 HMRs. So that's kind of the trend in the market, and it's kind of a good idea. That's what I definitely decided to do. So you have to figure out which silencer you want to get. The next thing you're going to want to have to do is, and this is definitely probably not in any order, I mean, you're going to have to figure this stuff out before you buy it, but you're going to have to figure out whether you want to file as an individual or file as a trust. Filing as a trust is going to enable you to be able to add people to your trust and in turn be able to pass it down to them if something were to ever happen to you. Now, if the HPA ever goes through, suppressors would end up being just like a pistol or something like that, where you would hand them down the same way in that regard. So if the HPA ever does go through, then trusts really aren't going to be that big of a deal. And the way the laws have been changed over the past couple years, trusts aren't as important as they were a few years ago. A few years ago, getting a trust was the easier way to go. Anymore, getting a trust is taking about 6 to 12 months right now. That's what I've been told. And filing as an individual is taking about 4 to 6 months. And that wait time is slowly coming down a little bit. So definitely kind of do your research. Again, I'm filming this video March 1st, 2018. So the times may be a little bit different depending on when you're watching this video. So I decided to order through Silencer Shop. As I said, Silencer Shop is going to make the process easier. Basically, what you're going to do is, as I said, figure out which suppressor you want, figure out whether you want to file as an individual or file as a trust. Once you figure that out, you're going to either call Silencer Shop up and order over the phone, or you can order on their website. What you're going to do is add this stuff to your cart, add the tax stamp to your cart, and you're going to pay for it. Or if you do it over the phone, they're going to send you an invoice via email, you're going to pay it, or they can take your credit card numbers over the phone, I think. And you're going to pay for it. Once you pay for it and everything, they're going to send you an email with a barcode. You're going to find a dealer local to you, and this is something that you're going to do before the fact. I forgot to mention it. You're going to have to find a local dealer near you that you're going to have your suppressor sent to so you can pick them up. Once you do that, you can go ahead and place your order and everything like that. After you get your order placed, you're going to get an email basically with your receipt, and it's going to have a little code on the top of it. What you're going to do is you're going to find a dealer local to you that has a Silencer Shop kiosk, and you're going to go in there, and it's going to be like a electronic voting booth, similar to the look of that. It's basically a touchscreen display, and it also has a fingerprint reader on it. You're basically going to do a little barcode, or you can enter the numbers manually into the system, and then you're basically going to do a background check. It's going to have you do your fingerprints. You're going to end up having to take a selfie in front of a plain white background, everything like that. And it's a pretty simple, easy process. It only took me roughly like 15 minutes to do it, and that's because my little ring finger on my left hand didn't want to register. I had to do it like 15 times to get it to go through. But after you do all this paperwork, you're going to be pretty much, for the most part, done. In about a day or two, Silencer Shop is going to send you an email with all the paperwork. You're going to read over that paperwork, and you're actually able to do an electronic signature on your phone if you have a touchscreen phone. So after you do that, all your paperwork is going to be completed. Silencer Shop is going to handle everything else for you. All you have to do is, again, enter all your information in that kiosk, do your fingerprints, make sure you take your selfie, and then sign those papers whenever you get them. After that, the wait time pretty much begins. As I said, right now, I've been told that trusts are taking 6 to 12 months. My local dealer that I went to do the kiosk, he kind of showed me some forms that have recently got approved. And most of the trusts that he's seeing have been around 9 to 10 months. That's kind of about the average, but there were some that took over a year, and there were some that only took about 7 or 6 months. Individuals have been going through in about 4 to 6 months. Most of them recently have been going through in about 4. So the wait times are definitely coming down for individuals, but they're starting to go up a little bit for trusts. So it really kind of depends. And again, times may vary as far as the wait times and everything like that. So the whole process is pretty simple and pretty easy. Now, there is a chance that you can get declined. I honestly don't know what to tell you if you get declined. I didn't do any research on that. But there is a possibility that, you know, if you don't have a clean record, you could get declined. You know, it's not an easy process. It's not like going into Walmart and picking up a box of cereal, going up to the register, paying for it, and going home with that box of cereal. It's not like going into a store, buying a gun, doing a background check, and then walking out the door with it. It's definitely a little more stringent and a little more time consuming, but I don't think it's something that's terrible to do. And I think that it's something that, you know, isn't a horrible experience. You know, is it the way I would like it to be? No, I wish it would be just like a gun where I do a background check and I get to go home with it and I don't have to pay a tax, but it is what it is. As I said, if that HPA or SHUSH Act or any of those similar acts ever go through, you're gonna have a really long wait time to get a suppressor, and the price is probably gonna go up. Also, as I said, there's going to be, you don't know when that act is going to go through, is what I'm trying to get to now. That act, you know, the SHUSH Act or the HPA Act, those were getting pretty close to passing around summertime of 2017. But with a lot of the most recent shootings, especially the one in Florida, you're seeing more anti-gun laws being introduced than pro-gun laws being introduced. So the possibility of that act going through in the next couple months doesn't necessarily look promising. Now, if it goes through, I'll be definitely thankful and I'll be happy, but the chances and the probability of it are pretty low. I've already waited about a year into Donald Trump's presidency hoping that the HPA would go through, and it hasn't. So you're going to wait either way, and you're going to pay either way, because as I said, after the HPA goes through, they're going to raise the price of them. That's just kind of going to be the way it is. So either way, you're going to wait. Do you want to take a chance and wait and hope that you can save money, hope that you can get a suppressor, or do you want to take advantage of some of the deals right now? And that's something I also haven't mentioned. Right now, there's a lot of deals. Silencer Shop, if you subscribe to their emails or follow them on Facebook or anything, you'll see they do flash sales all the time where, for example, and the reason why I got two suppressors was because they had a deal if you bought a Sig Sauer 30 caliber silencer, you would get a SRD 22X, which is their 22 silencer, which is about a $500 silencer. Supposed to be one of the best 22 silencers you can get. You got that for $100. Now, the caveat is I did have to pay two $200 tax stamps, but I'm getting two suppressors for around $1,100 was my total. And I got the Sig silencer for $600, so the 30 cal silencer. So basically, I got $700. I paid $700 for silencers and paid $400 for a tax stamp, for two tax stamps. So it wasn't a bad deal. There's some good deals out there. That deal isn't going on right now, I don't believe, anymore. I think Silencer Shop only did it for a couple of days, but they do deals similar to that. Right now, I think they're doing a deal on Q suppressors. I think it's like $100 off, or, you know, you get a chance to win a rifle if you buy a Q silencer or something along those lines. But just go over to Silencer Shop's website and look at it. They have a lot of promotions and stuff going on from time to time. So guys, ordering a suppressor, I definitely think it's a good idea to do it now. Get your weight in, just, you know, buy it and forget about it, and hopefully, you know, it'll be here before you know it. And you'll get it, and while everybody else is waiting for the HPA to go through, you'll be having fun out at the range shooting your can. So this is going to be a multi-part video. Whenever I get my suppressors in, I'll probably do a video and show them to you guys, and then it'll probably culminate with reviews on both of the suppressors. So I'm excited to get the suppressors in. I'm excited to, you know, have bought my first suppressors, and I definitely think it's a wise investment, you know. So guys, thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, feel free to post those in the comment section below. Go take a look at some other videos. I have a lot of videos up on guns, you know, pistols, rifles, everything like that. I'm not really a big shotgun guy, but we will be doing some shotgun videos in the near future. Stay tuned. God bless. Remember to train hard, shoot fast, and always be safe. Take care, guys.